What we're doing here, dealing? First off, whatever transpired between you and those kids gets squashed. No vendetta, no dit. You tell me it's over and it stays that way.
Would you prefer that I respond point by point, or should I wait till the end?
You can wait till the end.
Okay.
Second, no one in your organization steps foot in Kentucky again. You keep to Memphis and you leave me and mine out of it.
Anything else?
No, that's it.
You see, the problem is, I entered into business with these kids and they pulled a slick one on me. I can't let that slide. And furthermore, I shouldn't have to.
You get in the weed business with teenagers and it's their fault when things go wrong? You're the type of fella that walks under a flock of birds and is surprised when he ends up with shit on his face.
Just because I knew your daddy, don't think I won't have you killed right now. See, Arlo knew when to walk away. Did you learn nothing from him?
Oh, I learned a bit. When I was a boy, Arlo had this scam, stealing mining equipment, shipping it south, trading it for cocaine. A couple of company men got wind of who was ripping them off, and they went after Arlo and his crew. They shot up a couple spots, including our house. They killed Casper Johns. Wasn't with the crew, was just living with us at the time. And then this other fella that Arlo had been running with since high school. You get what I'm saying? Even before I went to Glencoe and trained to be a dead shot, I seen people kill one another. And I learned to be ready in case they came after me to do me harm. In other words, I'll kill four of you before you even clear your weapons, and I'll take my chances with the other two. And you see this star? That's going to make it legal. Now, do we have an understanding here?